What you're hearing right now is not the Detroit Symphony. It's MuseScore 2.1, using Sonatina Symphonic Orchestra, a free SFC sound library. Hi, I'm Isaac Weiss, here to briefly show you some of what's new in MuseScore version 2.1. In MuseScore 2.0, the SFZ playback engine, which we call Zerberus, worked well with the Salamander Grand Piano Library, but not so well with other SFZs. Now, you can load pretty much any SFZ, assign it in the mixer, and it will just work. See the links in the description below to download and install free SFZs. MuseScore 2.1 introduces three new ways to enter notes with a MIDI keyboard. Two are variations of real-time MIDI input, with some limitations, such as no support for tuplets. And the third allows you to enter a rhythm with the numbers on your computer keyboard, and then play the music freely on your MIDI keyboard. See the link in the description below for a fuller explanation. Clipboard commands, or cut, copy, and paste, are essential functions of any software. Now, MuseScore 2.1's editing tools are enriched with a fourth function, swap, or swap with clipboard. This command exchanges the contents of the clipboard and the selected measures in the score. So, if you want to swap two things, say measure A and measure B, select measure A, cut, select measure B, swap, which pastes the original contents of measure A into measure B, and simultaneously copies measure B to the clipboard, and now, paste into measure A. Another new function can be found at the bottom of the layout menu, Regroup Rhythms. This command will rewrite a passage to obey the standard rules for showing beat divisions, according to the time signature. In measure 5 here, the half note crosses the so-called invisible bar line in the middle of the measure, making the rhythm confusing to read. Regroup Rhythms can fix it. Now, it's correct according to standard notation rules. Under the File menu, the Save Online function allows you to send your score to MuseScore.com, where you can keep it for a private backup or share it with others. But MuseScore.com's score player, until now, would always render the score with all default synthesizer settings, even if you were using a custom sound font. Now, you can make sure that the online version sounds exactly the way you have it set up to by simply checking this box. And MuseScore 2.1 will generate and upload an MP3 audio track along with the score. Also, if you're updating a score you already have uploaded, there is a new field where you can keep a log of the changes. Those are the headline features to check out, but they're far from all. There are several other significant new features not mentioned in this video, many tweaks to the user interface, and dozens of increasingly obscure bugs fixed, including some that could cause a crash or a corrupted score file. Check out the release notes, linked in the description, for a full list of the more than 300 major and minor improvements in MuseScore 2.1. Happy scoring!